Welcome back to my channel. Today we have an amazing special guest. Her name is Makayla and she happened to be my niece. So this is my sister's daughter, but I'll let her introduce herself and yeah, we'll take it from there.
Hello, beautiful watchers. I'm Makayla and I'm 11 years old and I am Ghanaian and Jamaican.
Yeah, so this is my lovely niece. She's Ghanaian and Jamaican, a beautiful mixture, and I'm here talking to her today because she actually visited Ghana for the first time.
Yes.
In December 2019, so I really want to speak to her about her experience in Ghana. But before we go into that, I really want to ask her actually a particular question. So Makayla, prior to going to Ghana, what did you see or what did you know about Africa, like from living in the UK? Was it positive, negative? Explain to us a little bit about that.
Ghana, I've heard many things about it. Many people that I know come from there. And I've just been hearing lots and lots and lots of negative things.
So what negative things have you heard? Like, you know, earlier we spoke and you were talking about things that you saw whilst watching television. So what is it that you see depicted in the West about Africa?
I see that children with lips cracking and they have to scoop water from lakes, so they don't have any clean water.
Okay, so would you say the images that you see here in the UK are positive or negative when it comes to Africa?
It's mostly negative.
Okay.
Yeah, I see.
It's mostly negative. So she's saying her experience is that she's mainly seen negative pictures regarding Africa. Now, when you went to Ghana, how was that experience? What did it match what you saw in the UK and what you saw on the ground when you were in Ghana?
Most of the things I saw on television were not true. Many people were just living their life in Ghana as if nothing was wrong. So most of the things I see on TV aren't true. But the most positive things, like during the London and Ghana, is that they both have nice people.
Okay. So, you know, you went to Ghana and from what I heard from like your mother and things, you had a really good time in Ghana. So can you let us know what was like one of your favorite things about Ghana?
My favorite thing about Ghana is when I went to this hotel, but we didn't actually stay there.
Mm-hmm. So it was a beautiful hotel.
Yeah.
Can you describe the hotel to us?
It was like, it had many fish and it kind of looked like a zoo, but it was actually a hotel.
Oh, nice. So you love that experience. We'll have to find out where that was that you went to, because you know, maybe other people would like to also visit it and also take their children as well. So another thing you did whilst you were in Ghana is that you visited the slave trade, like the slave castle in Accra. Can you tell us more about that experience?
Well, so we were going on a little trip and when I got there, I saw like this huge castle and I was like, oh, what's that? And then my family were like, oh, this was the slave castle.
Mm-hmm. So can you tell me a little bit about that? Like what you learned, just a little bit, just let our viewers also know what you learned.
I learned that when it was like at the slave castle, there are many black people that were there and being enslaved.
Mm-hmm. So you learnt a little bit about slavery.
Yeah.
And what happened at that time. Did you know about slavery prior to going to Ghana? Did you learn anything at school in the UK about slavery?
Not that much, but I guess all I learned was like most of the black people came from Ghana, I mean like Africa.
Yeah.
And that they were shipped off back to Britain.
Britain, okay. You know, you actually mentioned like earlier on when we were talking behind the scenes, you mentioned Rosa Parks. What do you know about Rosa Parks?
Oh, Rosa Parks, she was a young lady who didn't like how black people were being treated.
Okay.
So, one day, she went onto a bus and sat down. And when a white person came, he was like, oh, I need to sit here, so get up, please. But he didn't move.
She didn't move. Okay, and that was a significant moment in the Rosa Parks story. Do you think that Rosa Parks did the right thing?
Yes.
Okay. So, overall, you enjoyed Ghana. What would be your message to them? And also young girls who are black, who don't appreciate their skin colour or don't love their skin. So what message would you want to tell young people out there?
Let me tell you, it doesn't matter what other people think of your skin, your nationality, your religion. Just be who you are, because no one can take that away from you.
Oh wow, you heard it from my niece. Be who you are, because nobody can take that away from you. Guys, if you're new to the channel, please do go ahead and subscribe. And don't forget to share this video and give it a thumbs up. Much appreciated. Take care now. Bye.